Good day all and welcome back to our channel. So today let's go through energy valuation in Odoo 14 community. So energy valuation refers to how you value your stock. So it's a very important aspect of a business as inventory can be the biggest asset of a company. So each time a product enters or leaves your stock, the value of inventory is impacted. So the way it is impacted depends on the configuration of your product. So for inventory valuation, mainly we have two choices. One is the costing method and other one is inventory valuation method. So we will be discussing about detail in the video. So this is the inventory module and here under configuration, we can configure product categories. So just open that and here we can see some pre-configured categories and we can create our own categories. So let me open one, create new category, and we can set a parent category here. Then we can set roots and first removal strategy for product category. Then here we can see a section to set inventory valuation, that is costing method and inventory valuation method. So for costing method, we have three options. One is standard price, then first in first out and average cost. So in standard price, any product will be valued at the cost that you define manually on the product form. So usually this cost is an estimation based on the material and labor needed to obtain the product. And we have second option, that is first in first out. So in this case, the products are valued at their purchase cost. So when a product leaves the stock, that's the first in, first out rule that applies. That is, first value in is the first value out. So no matter the storage location, warehouse or serial number. Then we have a third option, that is average cost. So in this case, each product has the same value and the value is the average purchase cost of the product. So with this method, the cost of product is recomputed as each receipt. So it does not change when the product leaves the warehouse. So the overall average will be taken. That is the former quantity into former average cost plus incoming quantity into purchase price divided by the final quantity. Then, okay, that's about costing method. And then we have inventory valuation method. For that we can value stock in automatically or manually. That is, in the case of manual, account entries will not be posted automatically. That is, account entries to value stock will not be posted automatically. We have to manually create it. Then in case of automatic, account entries will be posted automatically. So when you choose automated, you can see here under account properties, a price difference account can be given. That is used to value price difference between purchase price and accounting cost. Then here we can set account stock properties. First one, stock valuation account, then a stock journal will be used for valuation. Then stock input and output account can be set. And it's also possible to set input or output account on specific location. Let me click on this. So these account properties are mandatory when you set inventory valuation as automatic because we are posting entries automatically. Then one important thing to note is that accounting entries will depend on your accounting mode. That is, it can be continental or Anglo-Saxon. So in case of continental accounting, cost of a good is taken into account as soon as the product is received in stock, that is when you purchase. But in case of Anglo-Saxon accounting, cost of good is only recorded as expense when the good is invoiced to a final customer. Okay. So now let's save this product category. And so I have set for this category costing method is average and inventory valuation automated. Okay, let me set the parent category all and save this. Now let's go to products and create some products. Remove AVG one. And I'm going to set the product type as storable. And here let me change the category to demo. Okay, then save this product. And again I'm going to create a new product. Okay, for this product I'm setting it if I'm going to create a new category. I'm going to set average and manual. Okay, so for first product we have set average automated. So in this case I've set as average manual. Now let's create a purchase order for these products. So here let me just set a unit price 50 for first product and for second product 55. Okay, now let me confirm this order, and after confirmation receive products and validate it. Okay, then you can create bill for these products. Okay, now let me check the product. You can see here the cost is updated to 50. Now, if I check accounting, that's invoicing. Journal entries, you can see here what entries posted for demo AVG 1, and you can see the journal inventory valuation. So here you can see the stock valuation accounts can be seen here, but the entry is only posted for the first product, because for second product we have set inventory valuation as manual, so we have to create manual entries. And if I create a purchase order for those products, okay, you can see the previous cost for the products. Now, if I change this cost unit price to 60 and for the second product 70, and the confirm order and receive product. And if I check the product, you can see now cost is updated for second product, you can see 62.50. The average value, average cost value is taken. So this is how average costing method works. And you can also check the inventory valuation report to view the valuation. Okay. Now let me create more products. To check how FIFO works. So let me create
product before demo, and yeah, and we set category demo, and we change the product category settings. Here I'm going to change the costing method to FIFO automated. Okay, so you can see changing your cost method is an important change that will impact your inventory valuation. Okay, so let me change this and save the product. Okay, so you can see cost is zero. Now, if I create a purchase order for this product, setting unit price to 50 and confirm order. And receive products. So one product is received with 50 rupees. Now let me create another quotation for the same product. With a different price, setting 60 and confirm order. And receive products. Now, if you check the inventory, if you check the product, you can see the price. The cost is cost taken is 50. That is the first for which we first purchase the product. Now, if I create a sale order, that is, if I sell this product, and validate the delivery. Okay, this is 3-step transfer. And now, if I check the product, you can see the cost is now updated to 60. Because now in our stock, remaining is product with value 60. Because we have sold the product with cost 50. Because the first in is the first out. And if you check the inventory, evaluation. So here we can find. So here you can see, first we have purchased for 50, then for 60, and the sold. We have sold for 50. And you can also see the entry created in accounting. So if you check invoicing. Under accounting, if you check journal entry, you can see entry created for FIFO demo product because inventory valuation is automated. Okay, and we can also find another option, that is standard price. So Here you can also find an option to set standard price. So when you set standard price, the cost you set in the form, product form will be taken. Okay, and for standard price and average cost costing method, well, we have an option that is, I will show you a different product. So let me open a product with a bill of material. So when you open this, and okay, it is at a standard price. So here we can find an option to compute price from bill of material. So you can see this option for average costing method also, but you cannot find this option for FIFO automated, FIFO costing method. Okay, so when you click on this, cost from bill of material will be taken and set for this product. So that's all about inventory valuation in Odoo 14.